Hola, I am Javier Romero, and in this video we are going to see the recursion section of the introduction part of our tutorial on easy answer set programming. So in previous videos we were seeing what were logic programs and the answer sets, and I was telling you that what I was saying there would have to be adapted a bit for logic programs with recursion. So this is the moment where we are going to see what is recursion and how are we going to handle it. Then to begin with, let's consider this simple example where we have this choice rule on A and then three normal rules, B if C, C if A, and A if B. And if we have a closer look at it, we will see that there's something curious happening here, right? Because we have this B if C, A if C, and A if B. So from B we go to C, C to A to B, and back here. So there's something curious happening here. But now let's move on and see what are the answer sets of this program. Initially we start with the empty set as always. Then we can apply the choice rule and we have the empty set and the set with A. And now follow me a bit. If we apply this rule B if C, both sets remain the same because C does not belong to them, so there's no effect, so to say. Now with C if A, after applying it, since here we have the A, we must add the C. And here there's no A, so everything remains the same. And now there's only one rule to apply, A if B, and B is not here, so nothing happens, B is not here, nothing happens. Right? So then at this point somebody could think, okay, then the answer sets of these programs are the empty set and AC. But I think you already know that this is not the way to go, right? Because what happens is that we have not applied the rules in order, right? Because we apply this choice rule, that's fine, but when we arrive here, this rule has C in the body, but there are still rules with C in the head to be applied. So then we have applied this rule not in order. And the same thing happens with this one, right? A is in the body, but there's still a rule with A in the head to be applied. So this application is not in order. Then we cannot claim that these are the two answer sets of this problem, because what we have said is that the answer sets are the result of applying the rules in order. Then we have to backtrack a bit and try to apply the rules in order. Then here we have applied this one. Then let's try to apply other rule. What would happen if we applied C if A? Oh, that's bad, because again, we cannot apply it because there would be this rule with A in the head left to be applied. And the same thing happens if we try to apply this rule A if B, because B appears in the body and there would be a rule here with B in the head which is left to be applied. Then what we see is that what we have seen before cannot be directly used here because there's no rule that we can apply in order. Then the question is, how can we handle these programs? To answer the question, let's have a closer look at the program that we have. These three rules we are going to say that are a set of recursive rules, because all the rules in this set depend on all the rules of the set. Let's start with the first one. B if C depends on C if A, because this has C in the condition and this has C in the head. Then this rule, the second one, depends on the third one for the same reason, because A is in the condition and here A is in the head. And similarly, the third one depends on the first one for the same reason. But these are kind of direct dependencies. We can also say that the first one depends on the third one because it depends on the second, and the second depends on the third one, right? So then we are also going to say that the first one depends on the third one. And similarly, since the first one depends on the third one and the third one depends on the first one depends on itself. So the first one depends on all the other rules, and it's easy to see that the same holds for other rules. So all the rules in the set depend on all the rules of the set. Now, what we were saying before is that we have to apply a rule when, for all the atoms in the body, all the rules that have those atoms in the head have already been applied, or there are no more rules left with those atoms in the head to be applied. Now, what, and then this can be rephrased now as follows. If we have a rule, and then we have all the other rules, so, and this rule depends on these other rules, then before applying this one, we have to apply all of this. But now what happens is that we have a rule that depends on another, but this another depends on the first one, so we cannot choose which to apply. This is what is happening here. They all depend on the other, so there's no way to decide which single one to apply. Right? Then what is the solution for this? It's something actually very simple and intuitive. Since they all depend on each other, what we can do is consider them as a single rule. And the single rule has the single rule, if C is in the set, gives you B, if A is in the set, gives you C, and if B is in the set, it gives you the A. And then about the, if we have to take into account, if we have to see what are the dependencies for this rule. So this rule, this set of recursive rules have in the body C, A, and B. Then to apply this in order, it must be the case that after applying it, there are no rules with C, A, or B in the head left to be applied. Or put it another, if we put it another way, so for every atom in the body of these rules, there are no, all the rules that have these atoms in the head, except for this one, have been applied before applying this one, right? Before applying this set of recursive rules. Then, now, then of course this set of recursive rules depends on this rule, because here A occurs in the body and here A occurs in the head. So of course we have to apply this after applying this one. But now the question is, what is the result of applying this new single rule, so to say? If we apply it, given that here there was the A with this rule, we should get the C, and nothing happens on this side. Then one could say, okay, we stop here, this is the result of applying this set of recursive rules. But this doesn't make much sense, because here, this rule is telling us that if C is in an answer set, then B must also be in the answer set. So this doesn't look like a real answer set for this program, right? Because actually what is happening is that we have applied, so this rule depends on this one. So once we fire this one, it may be the case that this tells us something new. And in fact, this is the case. If we apply the rules all together again, then we get the B here. Right, because from this, using this rule, we get the B. And again, then we have to see, okay, now we have obtained this B, then maybe firing, applying the rules once more, we get some new atoms. So we have to see whether we obtain something new. But now when we apply it, nothing else can be added to the set. Nothing, these two sets are the same as the ones that we had before. And now it's easy to see that if we keep applying the rules, then they will stay the same, because if now we apply it here, we will get again the empty and the one with A, C, and B, right? So then what we will say is that the result of applying this set of recursive rule are these two sets, right? So because the result of applying a set of recursive rule is the result of applying them repeatedly until nothing changes. Good. And then now what we have is that, considering the set of recursive rules as a single rule that is applied in this way, that we apply it repeatedly until nothing changes, then this gives us the answer set of this program. Again, we apply the rules in order, but we consider that the recursive rules are like a single rule that has to be applied repeatedly until nothing changes. And then we come to these two sets, the empty one and ACB, and we know these are the answer sets of this logic program. And now for the methodology, this set of recursive rules has to go after this one, because these rules depend on this one, because these rules have A in the head, sorry, in the body, and A occurs here in the head. And then what we do is we may leave a space between these two, and here we put them more closer to show that this is a set of recursive rule, and we could even add here a comment to remind the reader of the program that this is a set of recursive rule. Good. Now we can come back to our UPython notebook and run this program example5.lp with Klingo. First we write the file and then we run Klingo, and we get the two answer sets that we expected, the empty one and the one with A, C, B. And here there's not really much more to show. Well, just a simple thing that we can comment all this rule with this symbol, right? This tells here it starts a comment and here it finishes the comment. So the three rules are commented, and then there's only the choice rule that gives us the empty set and A, right? And then here we are back at this part of the program only with the choice rule that gives us these two. And if we uncomment the rules, then we get the answer sets that we were expecting, right? The empty set and A, C, B. We have seen a set of normal rules that are recursive. Now let's see a set of choice rules that are recursive. And the situation is very similar to what we had before. Again, the rules are recursive because the first rule depends on the second, and it also depends on the third one, and it depends on itself. And the same thing holds for the others. Right, then now how to handle this set of recursive rules? The same story as before. We will consider them as a single rule. And again, as before, this set of recursive rules that is considered a single rule depends on the choice rule, because here we have the A and this rule outside of this set contains A in the head. So this has to be applied after this one. And then we have to apply this set of recursive rule, and what we do is we apply them repeatedly until nothing changes. Then if we apply it once, the empty one, nothing happened, and you will see here that nothing will happen because the rules also change something if there's already some atom inside. But for this side we have A, then with this choice rule we may add C to the set. Then we have these two options. Now one could think again, oh, we stopped now, but we have to apply it again, because now that we have added this C, new things may be generated. And this is in fact the case, because for AC, with this choice rule here, if we have the C, we may add B. So here it stays the same, but here we add the B. And for the A, again, we may have the same one, but applying the choice rule, we have the C. And see here, this is exactly the same step as what we were doing here, right? So, and this AC can be generated either from here by means of the application of this choice rule, or from here by means of the application of basically nothing, because you wouldn't have to apply anything specifically to get it back again, right? So we get it also from here. And yes, then these are the sets that we have at this point, and if we apply it again, then we see that we obtain the same sets. Again, from A we get these two, from AC we get these two, and from ACB that was not there before, we obtain this, the very same set again, right? So then if from here we get to the same set, if we apply it again, then the same thing will happen. So it doesn't make sense to apply the rules anymore, because we will always stay with these four sets of atoms. And then what we say is that the result of applying this set of recursive rule starting from these two sets are these four that we had before, right? And then what has happened now is that we have applied the rules in order, considering the set of recursive rules as a single rule that has to be applied repeatedly until nothing changes. And then we can say that, since there are no more rules left to be applied, that these are the answer sets of this program. And now we can go as before to our UPython notebook, and we write here this file example6.lp, That is what we had before, and when we run it, we have the four solutions that we were obtaining before. And to go up in the tree, we could comment these three rules, and then we would be only left with the choice rule and would have what we have at this level, right? Okay, then let's move on. And here we have another example of recursion that I have called combined recursion, because we have a set of recursive rules, and some of them are normal rules and other choice rules. And how are we going to handle this combined recursion? Well, this is similar to what we have seen before. We will consider the set of recursive rules as a single rule, but the application of this set of recursive rules, where some of them are normal and some of them are choice, is a bit more involved. So then what we will do is we will see this later. Okay, also what happens is that you will not see this combination of recursion with normal and choice rules. So this is also not really an issue. And also I want for you to keep this simple idea so far that whenever you have recursion, you just have to consider the set of recursive rules as a single rule that has to be applied repeatedly until nothing changes. And we will see this combined recursion later. Then this finishes this video on our first examples on recursion. And if you have questions or comments, please write them down below. And I hope you like it. And I hope to see you in another video. Stay tuned. Ciao.